What the fuck? Barbara!
What?
Barbara!
What?
Where my hoes at?
They've taken the day off, boss.
Taken the day? It's the busiest night of the year.
I know.
Well, go and get them.
Fine. I had shit I wanted to do, you know.
For fuck's sake. Right, well, it's Christmas, isn't it? I don't know why I had to specify that. Literally happens every year. And what good is Christmas without a little bit of festive outrage, eh? Maybe someone made a greetings card that isn't to your liking. Perhaps you take exception to all the delicious meat that's consumed. Or you could be one of those twats who complains about TV adverts. Well, whichever one you are, don't worry. I've got you covered with one simple internet search. Because as the saying goes, 'tis the season to be a self-righteous asshole. Let's kick off with a bit of douchebaggery from the people of Facebook.
Dad gone wrong. Why this family's Christmas photo is causing outrage.
Oh yes, photos are the new genocide, people.
A Christmas photo shoot meant to be a joke has the entire internet up in arms.
Bit of a grand statement, isn't it? The entire internet? I don't think the entire internet has ever agreed on anything. Except that time Peter tried to change the saying kill two birds with one stone to feed two birds with one scone. Then everyone agreed that Peter had lost his fucking mind and it was a beautiful moment.
An image from a family's Christmas photo shoot recently went viral after being posted on a Louisiana-based photographer's Facebook page, Hannah Hawks Photography.
Nice bit of advertising there. Normally, you only get a newspaper article about your business when you refuse to work at a lesbian wedding.
The picture of a family of five at a Christmas tree farm shows the two young girls and their mother bound with Christmas lights and their mouths covered in green duct tape, while the father holds a sign that says peace on earth, and the young son stands beside them, grinning, giving the camera a thumbs up.
And here's the photo in question. Aw, it's nice, isn't it? And clearly funny to anyone with a functioning sense of humour, but this is the current year, people. We can't have humans going around making jokes, not when the world needs feminism. And by feminism, I mean pointless moaning about certain things having an anti-female sentiment. So the photo was taken down and the person behind Hannah Hawks Photography, who I can only guess is Hannah Hawks, made a statement on the Facebook page like it was some kind of press conference for easily offended wusses.
After being silent, now isn't that ironic?
No, no it isn't.
I would like to speak. I've been called every name in the book.
Any chance I can get a copy of that book? Sounds like it'd be a damn good read.
And received some very hateful and vulgar comments and messages, I would like to say that as a female, I do not and have never promoted violence to women.
Could have just said violence, you know? Specifying a particular gender makes it sound as though you're more than up for smacking the shit out of a man. Maybe you are, I don't know.
I do not support abuse or the degradation of women.
Again, just say abuse and degradation. It's getting a bit worrying now.
My controversial photo was taken by request by the family and was in no way meant to promote abuse.
It boggles my mind that some people think this is promoting abuse. Like some wife beaters looking at it going, yeah, tie them up with Christmas lights. Nice idea.
The photo was taken with humour in mind and was meant as a comical Christmas photo. I personally know this family and have known them for many years. They are not abusive to their children in any shape or form.
Yeah, well, that doesn't matter now the guy's been judged in the court of Facebook, does it?
Also, I would like to add that no one was harmed during the process.
What the? Was anyone thinking that? Did anyone think the father slapped some tape over the girl's mouth and went, take a photo, quick! Now get one of her with a black eye!
So everyone have a wee Christmas and may God bless you and yours.
Bit of a possessive note in there with the you and yours, but no one's picking up on that. And I don't think she meant the wee bit, it's just the photo got cut.
I got one!
Oh, hang on.
Get the hell in there!
You can't make me.
I fucking can.
Oh, that's racist.
Ah, I see you found one of my hoes. Well done, Barbara. And do you have anything to say for yourself, Blunkle?
No.
All right, get back out there and make me some motherfucking money.
No.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I thought. There are still two more out there, Barbara.
I know. Fucking asshole.
Well, oi! Right, well, while she's doing that...
Activist removed from store after harassing customers.
Yep. The vegans are at it again, making sure the rest of the world is just as miserable as they are.
Vegans have targeted a UK supermarket by staging a demonstration in the turkey aisle as they protested against Christmas meat. The activists were seen encouraging shoppers at the Waitrose store in Brighton, England to shun animal products as they held up plates covered in fake blood.
If you really want to piss off a vegan holding a plate full of fake blood, dip your chips in it.
The vegan group, called Direct Action Everywhere, walked into the store waving placards saying, it's not food, it's violence.
Violence. And not violence towards women, which is also delicious, but violence towards animals, which, I mean, if we weren't meant to eat them, they wouldn't be made out of meat, would they? Your move, vegans.
Eventually, a member of the store's security staff arrived and said, outside the store is different. Inside the store, it's people's business and livelihoods. At one point, the protesters stood still as a man attempted to access meat on a shelf behind them.
That is so fucking British, that is. Some fuckwads have formed a human chain around the meat section, but that won't stop us from getting our sirloin steak. And I bet he was polite about it too. Like, excuse me, millennial cockwomble, you're in the way of my dinner. I strongly advise you step aside before I give you a jolly good beating. And you get bonus points if you make a vegan cry because tears are an animal product.
They eventually left to jeers from customers who included a bachelor party where the groom-to-be was chained to a dwarf.
What? Chained to a... That's a weird detail to include. I like it. Why weren't any of the vegans swarming around the dwarf chanting about midget cruelty? And were they mates with the little man or did they hire him? And if so, where? And did they include what was going to happen or what they were planning?
Both.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Get your ass in there.
Oh, no.
I got another one, boss.
Ah, Chinkle, you have returned.
Oh, chong-o-do-do-do.
I can't understand what he's saying.
He called you a prick.
Oh, well, in that case... His face didn't change.
No, he always looks like that.
Right, okay then. Now get back out there, ho. He's a hard worker, that one.
I know.
Two down, one to go, Barbara.
Yeah, I got this.
Now, I don't know if you've seen it, but Sainsbury's threw out a Christmas advert. It was the normal shit, kids singing songs on a stage, but then this motherfucker comes in dressed as a plug and boom! Jumps in the socket with perfect form and just kind of hangs there. Fucking fantastic. I loved it. But guess who didn't love it? Only the 35 people that were worried it would encourage children to jump into plug sockets. Yeah, that's right. How fucking mental are these people? I mean, there was also a kid dressed as a turkey. Why didn't they say anything about that? Aren't they worried that might encourage children to climb into the oven for 2 hours? Honestly, where do these people find the time? Haven't they got other things to worry about? Like, come on, Ken, we've got bills piling up and we haven't made a mortgage payment in 3 months. Can't you get off the phone with the complaints watchdog and just enjoy a nice family dinner? And Ken goes, we've got to think of the children, Karen. Someone out there might be taking a whimsical advert too seriously and placing themselves in a state of mild peril.
I got him.
Ah, speaking of mild peril.
Here's the last one, boss.
Oi.
Is that one of ours?
Well, sure. It's Cackle.
Really? Wow, we're gonna pay for that one.
Oh, yeah. He'll always find a way to make you pay for something.
I didn't mean like that. Fucking hell, Barbara.
What?
Ah, nothing. Well, what's the point in even saying?
Aren't you gonna pimp slap him?
Yeah, I would, but in the current social and political climate, I can't be seen slapping a Jew. I'm just gonna end the video. Go on, get out of here.
Pussy.
Thanks for what? Did she just. What a bitch. Thanks for watching, guys. Please consider becoming a patron to ensure I get nice and merry this Christmas. And check me out on BitChute because tis the season of checking things out on BitChute. The links are in the description. And remember, ho ho ho. Ha ha, that's better.